All right, welcome back to another video. This time we're focusing in on this guy, the base of my monitor you're always seeing in my videos. But this is a computer. So let's kick it off with a little Aerosmith. Face getting clearer. The past is gone. It went by like dust to dawn. Isn't that the way? Everybody's got the do's and life to be. Okay, that's it. That's my obligatory, I have to put something on my videos to try and screw the ad man, because I notice if I put copyright music on my on my videos, they don't seem to advertise on it. So there you go. That's my trick. Maybe somebody else is maybe everybody else should do the same thing and see how. I mean, I guess you can't monetize it, I guess, but I don't monetize, so at least you don't get ad bombing. All right, so let's get back down to business here. So that's what we're focusing in on, is my Lenovo ThinkCenter M576071 desktop. And I'm just going to go up a level here, and I'm going to show you all the drivers you're going to need. I'm going to post these to archive.org. And these will be going up, because if you happen to have one of these guys right here, you are going to want to have these drivers. You can pause it if you want to take a look. So let's zoom back over to normal view. And what we're going to do tonight is we're going to look at some of the specs. And yeah, give this thing a look-see. And then we'll run NovaBench, because that's what I like to do, just to see where it all shakes out. So I think that's pretty cool. It's a pretty cool way to highlight this computer. So to start with, if we go to this here, this is kind of the breakdown of the system. And actually I'll go to hardware too. I'll show you something about the device manager. It's clear, that's what we want. So those drivers will clear up the device manager. Now here's the thing, this thing was originally had Windows 7 on it, but I took that off because I discovered, as a Windows 7 machine, this is a pretty crappy computer. But as an actual Windows XP machine, then it's a decent computer. So that's why I went with the old XP Service Pack 3. And yeah, so you can, as we can see from some of the details here, it does have a Core 2 Duo CPU running an E8200 at 266 gigahertz, and it has about 3 gigabytes of RAM. Now, that kind of summarizes the basics of that. But let's talk about the actual reason why I'm not using it with Windows 7. I got a lot of Moyer effect going on here. Let's see if I can do this. So let's zoom in here. So if we look here, we can see that it's running an Intel Q35 Express chipset family type driver, a GMA 3100. And It has 384 megabytes of memory that it can use. So it's not bad. Like it'll give you basic graphics, better than some, but certainly not great for what you'd want to do with Windows 7 with the Aero interface and all that jazz. I mean, it'll run it, but it just doesn't, it's not a great Windows 7 machine. Here's the basic rundown of what I got on here. I'm using a 32-bit Service Pack 3 XP OS, and it says it has 4, but you know what? I'm gonna show you something. It's wrong, because if you look here, that's one of the things I noticed about this program. It's got it has DDR2, it's got 2 gigabytes there of that stick. But if you go to the second stick, what has it got? Oh, it's got 2. So is it telling me that it has 4? Okay, it does have 4. Well, then why did it say that it had 3? Oh, maybe because it's using some of the RAM? Let's see something down here. 3 gigabytes of RAM. I don't know. There's something fishy going on here. Let's take a look over here. Just discovered something radical. Oh, no. There it is. It says 4. Let's open it up. Slot 1, 4. Interesting. Oh, slot 2 is empty. Slot 3 has 2. Yeah. So, yeah. Okay. There you go. For what it's worth. It does have 4, but other systems seem to be saying it has 3. So, not sure why that is. At any rate, we got ourselves a Wolfdale. And, it's got the, it's a Core 2 Duo, as we can tell from the sticker. Core 2 Duo inside, a little scuffed up, but there you go. It has all the basic stuff you would want for a XP system, actually far beyond. And it's got 2 cores, 2 threads, which is, excuse me, usually what I like to have when I'm using a system like this. And its BIOS aren't too bad at 2009. And we already mentioned the graphic situation. So yeah, that is probably the weakest link on this one. And like I said, I'm noticing that it's not giving us the right amount of RAM here. But it's also identifying the CPU as a Xeon Pentium 3. But in reality, if you have this hotfix installed, it will give you the right identification. So apparently this is the problem. I just have to find where I can get that from, because Microsoft support does not have that hotfix available anymore on the internet. So have to hunt it down at some point. In the meantime, we can just know that it's wrong. But yeah, this is a pretty decent system. So it has, well, let's get the shine off the there. Yeah, it has, summary, it's running good temps, which is always what I look for. It should, because there's nothing happening with this system. It seems to identify the right amount of RAM. It's DDR3 at 333 megahertz, so yeah, it's, you know, it's okay. And it's got it says 150 hard drive. I think it's bigger than that. That's a good question. Let's see if I can find Crystal Disk Info. Crystal Disk Info. Let's see if I can find it. There we go. Let's do that. Let's get that going. Okay. Yeah. So, yeah, it's at 160, as we can tell, at Western Digital. And, you know, it's got how many hours? It's got a lot of days, about roughly 2,000 days. So it's, you know, it's real. It's been used. It's got no signs of, it's saying good. Health is good, so it has no signs of horrible wear or tear, so that's cool. But yeah, that's the hard drive info. I've got an optical drive. It works. I installed Windows XP on it with it, and it has the old SoundMax audio. So, you know, nothing special. Onboard stuff. But like I said, the big challenge this thing has is producing graphics. And this is sitting out here over out of the way. Okay, it's even got the wrong date on here. Don't mind that. All right. So let's the big question is, how does this thing rate? And why is it doing that? Okay. Let's see. I got a little bit of an artifact. I guess from this. Watch this. I got an app that does this from time to time. Sorry, guys. I think I will just get rid of it. It's actually this guy here. This one here does this. Makes it. And it leaves it. Well, still left the artifact. Even despite it not being working. Wow. Okay. All right. Well, that's new. Oh, no. It's gone. Okay. Good. All right, guys. So, getting back to the point, we're going to start the Nova Bench score thingy. Oh, and this is running. So, let's close that. I can just close it. I don't need to save it or anything. Cancel. Come on. No, I don't need to save it. Okay, let's do it. Bench me. Oh, yes. I'm going to let the floating point thing go. And I might as well take a second out to say, what am I drinking today? I'm drinking Harp Lager. It's a product of, on the English side, because I live in Canada, brewed in Ireland with a shaky hand. I figured I'd just take a sip while we're waiting for RAM transfer speeds. Okay, here we go. This is the big finale. The big finale. How's it doing? It's blocking it. Well, 24 frames per second. Not great. It takes a hit at having pixel shader two shaders of being two, so 50% score reduction. And so let's see what we got. And that's really the reason why it's XP. It just doesn't really have the capability of doing what I want it to do. So yeah, here we go. Score of 312 frames per second. Probably, I guess, average or something. So that's the weakest link here. Everything else is fine. So that's why this became my one and only XP desktop. And why don't I put a CPU in here? I mean, a GPU in here. Put a discrete graphics card in there. Well, the reason is this thing's a half height. And if you've seen the tiny power supply this thing has, you don't want to put anything on it that isn't already on it. It just doesn't have capacity if you're running a decent graphics card. So, yeah, it's kind of what it is, right? It's a small form factor. It's quite small, as you can see. I don't know if you can see that. It's quite small. It's a very small little system. Yeah. Oops, I guess I'm showing off the COA. Anyway, but yeah. So it's not great that way. But for an XP system, it's ideal. So there you go. That's going to be it. That's a fairly long video, but just wanted to share with you one of my computers in my collection. Oh, and by the way, I'm going to warn you guys. This is something I discovered. Maybe this will save you guys a lot of trouble. If you guys have the idea of using like the unofficial service pack 4 for Windows XP, I can't recommend that because it got halfway through the process, crashed, and continued to do the exact same thing every time I ran it. And then it it ruined my Windows File Explorer. Every time I opened my File Explorer, it crashed. So I had to reinstall it. So my recommendation is don't. Just don't do it. It's real dumb. It's somebody's, you know, it's not official. Somebody's project that they've cobbled together. And yeah, I wouldn't recommend it. Unless you like spending, you know, your evening reinstalling the OS and every app that you like to use on your OS, which, you know, takes hours. So I don't recommend that. Anyway, guys, whoops, shaking this thing all over the place. Anyway, guys, that's going to be my video for this time around. I hope you're having a great evening. I hope you like my funky Think Center. Let's open her up. There you go. See, that works. So it's like a little, it is a DVD and CD-R writer, but it's like the really thin one, right? So it's almost like a laptop one. Anyway, there's that. And you get some I.O. I don't want to show you the I.O. in the back because it would be a pain. But yeah, it's pretty good. It's got good air intake right through here. And yeah, it's actually got a fair bit of I.O. I just basically run these cords out from behind, you know. And of course, I got my Roswell mechanical keyboard. And guess what I found the other day at Value Village? It's a Devastator 2 Cooler Master. So yeah, it's a, it's not bad. It's okay. Let's see. Whoops, I got some beer on it, I guess now. Or some beer sweat on it. Anyway, it's okay. It's an okay mouse. It's nothing to write home about, but you know, it works. I can't say it's a bad mouse. It's good, especially when it doesn't have beer sweat on it. So guys, that's it. That's going to be all. Hope you're having a good evening. It's Friday night. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm